Hi, I'm Jason Hobbs. In this video, I'm going to walk you through the process that I used to update my website, jasonhobbsllc.com, a couple of days ago. And the idea behind it was I didn't feel confident that my online marketing was organized. And so I wanted to fix that. And most importantly, I wanted to prepare it so that I could start personalizing my marketing going forward. And I organize it and personalize it using RightMessage app. So the homepage is kind of where we're going to focus on as far as so that you can see the changes as far as the new setup. So I'm using Monochrome Pro. It's a child theme by studiopress.com. And I just keep it as simple as possible. This is the, you know, when you land on it, this is above the fold, if you will. And then as you scroll down, the next row is where you'll actually see my funnel show up, which is which best describes you. And it's asking the first of my segmentation questions. Now, this is the first iteration of this new funnel. So it only has two offers in it, and it only has two segmentation questions in it as well. So that's the first one there. And so before I went in and built the actual funnel, and I'll show you that in a few slides, but before you get to that, you want to answer some questions for yourself. The first questions that I answer is, what offers are going to comprise this marketing funnel, right? And keep in mind, you can have as many offers as you want to add in the future, but starting with these two will actually, you know, impact your business, right? So typically, with everyone I've seen over the last few years doing this, it's going to start out with a free email list. Like, that's the first offer that they're going to take a, you know, the business up on. And then the second one for me is I want them to book a free 30-minute call with me. And so those are the two offers that they're going to go, you know, run into. And keep in mind, one of the great things about RightMessage app is you're not showing people something that they've already done. So if you're already an email subscriber, you come back to my website, it's not going to ask you again to sign up for the email list because it knows that you're already a subscriber. Instead, it's going to use that real estate on the screen of my website that you're viewing, and it's going to offer you what's the next step for you. And obviously, you know, over time, it could be that you're now on the 10th offer. So that's a really big thing for me, is just you're not wasting people's time, and you know, it's not creating a bad user experience is the goal. So two offers, you need to define those for yourself. I obviously, as I said, these are mine. And the two questions, typically I have everybody start out with the same question. And I stole these from Brennan Dunn. He's the guy, Double Your Freelancing. You may have heard of him. He's been on a bunch of different podcasts and so forth over the years. But he's also one of the co-founders of RightMessage. And so I stole this from him because it just made so much sense, which is the segmentation questions. When you're segmenting your email list, the first question that you want to ask and get answered by each subscriber is, who are they? For context, if you're a veterinarian, right, then the people that show up at your website could be a cat owner, a dog owner. They could own a dog and a cat. They could be a farmer. They could run a local nonprofit shelter. They could be the local humane society. And all of these would be viable customers. But obviously, each of them is going to want something different because each of them has different priorities, right? And then the second question is, what do they want from the business? So once again, going back to the veterinarian example, then they may have an issue that occurred with one of their animals. So they're looking to figure out what's going on with this, or they're looking to, you know, schedule a doctor visit. Or maybe it's a case where they want to, you know, get set up on automatically having their food shipped to them. You know, any number of different possibilities. So you want to know the who, and you want to know what they want from your business. And you want to be able to save that for each one. And we save that in your email service provider. When you're using RightMessage app with your website, you have those two connected, and then you have your email service provider connected to RightMessage app as well, okay? And so in with this setup, you're going to keep all these, the data, the information that you're learning, the single source of everything, the overriding one, is going to be the email service provider. So it comes in through RightMessage. They'll answer the questions there, but it's going to be stored in whichever, with me, ConvertKit, you know, for that each individual user account, each individual subscriber. So once you've answered those two, you've figured out, hey, these are my two offers to start with, these are my two questions, then, you know, where will the form show up on your website? And they all offer five different ways you can do it. Like, you can have a full screen takeover, you can have a pop-up, you can have a bar across the top, you can have a toaster, which shows up in the bottom right-hand corner, or you can have an embedded widget where you actually embed it, say, in a widget area on your website or in the sidebar or whatever. And that's what I'm using for my website. So here, here that is an embedded widget that I've embedded into my homepage, right? So after you've answered those questions, now you're ready to go in and actually build the marketing funnel version one of it in RightMessage app. And so here is an example. This is an example of, actually, yeah, so I have three questions. I lied. I forgot about that third one. And so you can see, this is what happens when you come to my homepage and that you scroll down to where that question that I showed you before is at. It's going to, the system is going to say, hey, is this person already a subscriber? And if they're not, it's going to show you the first question. And then once you answer it, it's going to show you the second question. And then once you answer it, it's going to then make the offer for you to join my email list. Now, if you show up and you're already a subscriber, well, number one, you've already answered those two questions, and it's going to ask you a third question, which in this case is, I call it how, and, you know, how do you plan on organizing this, tackling the organization of your marketing? And, you know, is it DIY? Do you want to do it all yourself? Do you want to pay me to do it all for you? Or do you want to do a mix of it? And so those are the three different options. And once they answer that question, then it's going to make the offer to book a video, a free 30-minute video call with me, which I do using Zoom. So this is the decision that you can see that green box there. The decision, with ConvertKit, it's just saying, hey, are they a subscriber? Yes or no? And so the segmentation questions, you can see in the back end, I'll show you here, under manage across the top there, then you'll see segmentation and questions. And once you click on it, it's going to actually, that left-hand column there is going to show the different segmentation questions. And once you click on one of them, that's when you'll see what you're looking at right here. And you can see that for each of the questions with the possible answers, there are three tabs that you're going to go through. We're not going to worry about the third one because I'm not using it to begin with, because I'm going to have everything be manual. Like, they're going to answer the question as opposed to me setting it up and having the auto segment. That's where I set the system up to, based on whatever action that they did, it would automatically segment them. So anyway, the first one there is, that's, you know, internal, you're naming this, and then the question wording, that's what they actually see, right? And then the possible answers, and you can add additional ones, and you can, you know, ask it to randomize the answers. I don't worry about that though. So, and then the second one is, this is where I synced the answers with ConvertKit. So as you can see, it's a custom field in ConvertKit that this is getting synced over to. I'm not using tags or a form or anything. So, because what I want to do is, with a custom field, it can only have one value, like only one. It can't have, I'm not marketing my business online and I've started marketing my business online, but it's not organized, you know what I mean? But those, if those were tags, it could technically end up with both of those. And we don't want that, because that's just confusing for us and it degrades the value. Well, actually it destroys the value because we don't know which one is actually relevant. However, in this instance, if they were to come back and, you know, say they answered with the, I'm not marketing my business online, and then they came back and changed the answer later, then it would just remove it, you know, it would replace it with the second one as opposed to keeping both, which would happen with tags. So, and as you can see, the who there by the custom field, that's the name that I gave it over in ConvertKit. So this is just the second question. I'm showing you those and, you know, that it's also done. And so RightMessage offers, once again, this is under, you know, when you're logged in to the back end of, or I'm sorry, to your RightMessage app, you see under Manage, there's going to also show up, when you click on Manage, it'll show segmentation, questions, and then it'll show offers and then widgets. And so, and now we're clicking on offers, right? And here we're actually, we've added a new offer, and what's happening here is a couple of things. So the simplest way to accomplish this, if you already have an email opt-in list, is to just use the same headline, the same copy, as far as the, you know, paragraph copy there, as well as the, you know, same, add the same fields. I only use email address, and then, you know, the same button copy as you are, you have currently, right? So you're just replicating that to begin with. You can come back and change it in the future. And so with mine, though, I did go a little bit more complex, I guess, because I wanted to go ahead and start using the a little bit of the personalization available. So I'll get into that in a second. But you can see the basics there. And then in the right-hand column, you'll see that, okay, under the submit options, when the button, the submit button is clicked, you know, that obviously they have to put their email address in, it's going to submit a ConvertKit form that I've already set up over in ConvertKit. And I call that the form email list one. You can see the little email list one, the blue button there, right? And then it's going to display this thank you message, which is please confirm your email address by clicking the link I just emailed you. And then it's going to redirect them to a success page. So let's talk through the personalization there. So the three-part email course on organizing your online marketing, I wanted to show a different headline based on what I know about them. So this is where I've set that up. And so the default phrase, as you can see, and then it's depending on the segment, the segmentation question, which is who, right? So I'm changing it based off of that. And I'm saying, okay, I'm not marketing. Okay, well then the three-part email course to begin marketing your business online. And then if it you said, hey, I'm marketing, but it's not organized, it's going to say the three-part email course to organize your online marketing. And so that's just a little bit different from the default. I probably could have just left it as the default. And then the third one is, you know, it's a marketing, it's organized, but it's not personalized. You can see it's, you know, to begin personalizing. And, you know, you set those up, and obviously it's going to show it based on, you know, the idea behind it is to help people see the value as far as how it can help them specifically, because you're talking their language. Don't collect the segmentation data and never use it. When, like, for instance, in the video that I did earlier today, as far as how to get started with RightMessage to, you know, organize your online marketing in under 40 minutes, you know, we didn't do any of this personalization, but you definitely want to do it once you start getting, especially once you start getting answers to people, you know, people answered your questions. So, all right, and then here's the second one, which we'll go back real quick. You see the organized there, and so that's here, and it's doing it off of the second question, which is the why question. And so you can see, instead of showing organized, it would show personalized, or it'll show learn how to organize, or learn how to personalize. So, and then, yeah, here's the third question that I had, the DIY, the mix, or the done for you. And, you know, once again, this syncing it with ConvertKit. So, oh, here's the second one. And this is the second offer that I have. So this is, if you're already a subscriber, you answered the third question, right? And then it's going to show you this, and it's going to show the picture of my mug. And then it's going to, you know, say, hey, do you want to talk to me via video call? Book your 30-minute video. I'm ready to pick my day and time. And you can see on the right, instead of submitting a form in ConvertKit or whatever, it's actually going to redirect them to the My Calendly page, where, or it's going to send them over to Calendly so that they can go ahead and book their time with me. So, and you can see that once again, I did, that's why it has that dotted line or whatever around it. You know, it's not going to just say that, talk to Jason. Actually, all of these are going to say different. So if you answered, I'm not marketing my business online, it's going to say, you know, learn where to begin marketing your business online. Or, you know, if it's, you know, said you're online but it's not organized, learn how to organize your marketing, learn how to personalize your online marketing, as far as for the third one. See, so, and the idea is that each of those people, they have a little bit, they're getting the same thing, but they're getting it for a different reason. And this allows me to address that different reason for each of them. So the website widget, it's real simple. Here's the trigger. You know, once you set it up, as far as that you want to create it, once you create it, you're going to have to give it a name. So Digital Worry up at the top is actually one. And it, you'll see it showing, hey, this is the RightMessage CTA funnel that it's showing, which is the LLC-2020, right? And then as far as I give this actual widget its specific name there, COVID-19 update. And actually, this is just a leftover from something I did a while back. But the point of it is, you see that little red div there? I need to copy the opening and closing div and then copy and I paste that into whatever widget or, you know, page or post or whatever that where I want it to show over on my website, because this is an embedded widget. So, and you can see, like, I could say only show it on these pages or hide it on these pages, but I don't worry about that because it's an embedded widget. So it's just going to show wherever it's embedded, right? And, you know, the number of questions to ask, I like to just leave it where, hey, any questions that they get to in the funnel, the most that they would be able to get to at one time is going to be two anyway. You know, the question one and then question two. So when you're on here, the style, the main thing you're probably going to want to mess with is going to be the contrast color at bottom left there. And, you know, for instance, I'm using my that aqua blue or whatever from my logo. And it before it was like the hot pink or whatever, you know, the like the little thing under the style, that color was used all over. So I changed it and just makes it, you know, match a little bit better with my website. So, all right. To show you where this is the finished product, right? So, you know, we put it together, and as I start getting some results from it and all, then I'll let you know. I'll come back and kind of update it. And as I update the funnel as well, because I'm going to be iterating it, this is definitely just the first version of this funnel. And, you know, so as I update it, I'll come back and, you know, do new videos kind of showing the different updates and all. If you have any questions or whatever about getting your online marketing organized using RightMessage, definitely you can reach out to RightMessage, or you can always email me, jason@jasonhopsllc.com. You can see in the upper right the contact Jason on my website. You can go there and there's a little form for you to fill out that emails me. You know, definitely avail yourself of that if you have any questions or anything's unclear, but you're looking at, hey, I'd like to organize my marketing, and I'd like to use my website, my email service provider that I'm using, as well as adding RightMessage, you know, to it. I'd be more than happy to, you know, kind of point you in the right direction, get you the answers that you're looking for. So thanks a lot. Have a great one.